and I married a man, and I have a daughter by him, and she's 8 years old. She's here, but we're divorced.
I met her. She's a lovely young woman.
Thank you.
You're divorced from her father.
Yes, I'm
so you were really, you had a lot of head problems, I assume, as a result of this.
Extreme. And trying to get work is not easy. Once the lawsuit was filed, it's like I was blackballed, you know.
Yeah.
People don't want to hire you once you file the suit. They don't want you in their home. Oh, I'm afraid if you trip, you know, you're going to sue me. And
really?
My little girl has that now. But, you know,
she's got the
mommy
who sues.
We've got some great friends, but we've got some people that, you know, they stay apart from us because they think, you know, I'm going to sue at the drop of a hat.
Right. Did a lawyer stick by you, or did you have problems there?
I got a lawyer years afterwards. Okay, years after we went through the hard part. I did get a lawyer there. At the end, my brains were fried. It was too emotional. It was very devastating to go through.
Right.
Okay?
Now, so you sued Caterpillar. You're the plaintiff. And I assume on Iowa, what would this be? Civil court?
Civil rights.
Not federal, civil.
And what we did was it went through the civil rights court. And they found that I had a case and that I won, okay, that it was considered discrimination. And we talked about going on to the federal court, and it was between those two that we did settle. Okay?
Uh-huh. So you settled out of court after 7 years for an amount which I assume you are not allowed to disclose.
That's right.
I'll bet you it's not $1 million.
I bet you're right. I'm working now.
So you have to wonder whether this was worth it even now, don't you?
Well, I'll tell you, I wish I never left General Electric, okay? It's a good company. I really wish I'd have stayed there. I wanted the dental program and more money. Do they own this company? They
you
own this
speak system. From the stage of a studio owned by General Electric.
Good company. They are great people.
Well,
they'll
never believe that. Now you got another problem. Now you're
sorry.
A setup. Okay.
Oh, no,
I accept
sorry,
this.
I'm
I accept the validity
sorry.
Of your very uninfluenced observation. And you're back at work now. At least you're not on welfare.
I'm working at a different company, a local company.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
And how are you now regarding your own self-image? I mean, is it still rattle around in your head? How much of the legacy of your childhood and the humiliation you felt, as Natalie did, lives with you today? I'm asking. And did you ever have therapy? And what do you do about this?
I went to a counselor shortly after my termination. And she says, I use too much body language. Here's a pregnant woman analyzing me, okay? Says, well, you use too much body language. So, you know, here I am talking with my hands already, okay? And so I tried to stifle myself and, you know, not be that way. Yeah, and I thought, who's this pregnant lady telling me? You know,
yeah.
I thought, well, if that's all that's wrong with me, I'll change it. So, you know, I've stifled myself a little. But I've just this past year, I've really gotten myself together mentally.
Yeah. Do you unconsciously find yourself covering yourself? I don't know, I'm asking.
Yeah, using props and, you know, I've always got my purse up here or something.
Really?
So, yeah.
And you're saying you think it's over now and you're, this is who I am.
I'm handling it better. I'm looking at it from a different perspective and handling it much better.
Yeah.
So.
You must have seen other women or met other women who were in similar circumstance, huh?
Very few.
Well, there's lots of them.
I know there is a lot
of them. And maybe we're looking for an association here of commonly afflicted, I say societally afflicted.
Huh? 4D Club.
4D.
40D,
yeah.
D-D-D-D.
Okay, we'll be back to listen to the likewise unfunny story of Christine Walsh Ramirez in just a moment.